Hey guys, Chris Camaro here, and today I'm going to be telling you how to diagnose and repair a Sony Bravia LCD TV. With the in this particular case, the code is KDL52XBR4, but there are other TVs that are similar to this that can benefit from the same sort of reasoning and diagnostics. So the problem with this TV is it tries to turn on, and if you look at the front, you'll see the Sony logo in the bezel. Blinking on and off, not regularly, like sort of randomly. As it attempts to fire up the display, and sometimes it even succeeds, but only for a few seconds and then it dies. So, and then after that you'll get the standby light will blink red several times. And depending on the weather, it seems to blink a different number of times. And Sony publishes a chart that tells you what those blink codes mean. But the problem with it is that it doesn't tell you exactly what the problem is. It gives you like three or four options as to what it could be, so you're still left guessing. So in this case, I get either three lights, which is most of the time. Sometimes I get eight, sometimes I get six. And that pretty much narrows it down to either the inverter board, the power supply board, or the main logic board. Now, I've had the main logic board, which is this one up here, I've had that one replaced already, and it didn't do anything. So, pretty sure that's not the problem. The inverter board, again, I don't really think that's the problem, because the TV works fine when it does work. So I doubt that the inverter is the issue. What my gut feel is that it's the power supply. I've already probed some of the voltages on these white connectors on the side here, which are the connectors that deliver voltages to the rest of the TV. And some of these voltages fluctuate, like they'll be stable in standby. And this is another problem I should mention, is that, you know, in my case, I had a technician over. He's supposed to be a TV expert, TV repair guy, you know, qualified and everything. He tests the voltages in standby mode and tells me that there's nothing wrong with the power supply. Well, you know, I'm not as educated as or as experienced as him, and even I could figure out that that was not a proper diagnosis. So I went and checked it again on my own time, except I had the TV attempting to turn on while I was doing it, and I saw the voltages fluctuating only when the TV was flickering. So this is something that he didn't catch, and unless you're smart enough to figure that out, that it has to have a load on it in order to cause the problem, you wouldn't necessarily see that problem. So just a word of warning that if you're going to check the voltages, don't just check it in standby. You know, try to turn the TV on and get it to try to fire up while you're checking it to see if you can load the TV down a little bit so that those voltages will actually either be stable or not stable, and that'll give you a clue. So anyway, this is my hypothesis, is that the power supply is bad. One other thing that you can do to verify this is if you have a basic understanding of how the TV actually functions when you hit the power button. So this is kind of TV operation 101. It gives you the basic intellectual framework to sort of use deductive logic to figure out why it would be this board and not another board. So here's how it works in a nutshell. You got your AC power coming in through this plug over here, okay? So this is your AC line. Goes into this connector here. This connector feeds the entire power supply board. It goes through a fuse, goes through some stuff over here. I guess these are filters or something. And then over here you've got a relay. And when you turn the TV on, you can actually hear this clicking. It'll click, indicating that it's releasing the power to the rest of the board to turn everything on. However, this doesn't just turn on instantaneously as soon as you hit the power button. Something in the TV decides to turn this thing on based on some criteria. So it's obviously not just triggered by voltage, it's triggered by some logic, which means that something else in the TV has to be on, even though this thing hasn't fired up the rest of the board. So there's got to be a bypass in here somewhere, and there is. There's a trace in the PCB that goes underneath here that bypasses the main voltage to some other part of the TV to decide, you know, whether or not to turn the relay on. Basically, whether or not the TV is okay to go. You know, whether everything's good and you can turn the TV on. So how this works is there's a standby voltage, which is 5 volts on this TV, and it's the fourth pin from the bottom here. So I actually have a spare board. Funny thing, I bought a replacement power supply, and the replacement was broken. But it's good for, you know, showing you stuff. So if you take a look at this bottom connector, fourth one up, it says standby 5 volts, okay? So that's voltage leaving the power supply board and going to the main board. And that's pretty much the only voltage you're going to get on the power supply until the relay turns on. So that connector goes out along here, and it goes to this green board over here, the one with all your inputs and stuff on it. This is also just called the main board. So 5 volts standby will go here. If this board sees the 5 volts, it'll send a signal back saying, okay, I see the standby volts, go ahead and attempt to turn the TV on. So this board will send back 3.3 volts, and again, it'll show up on this same connector, but instead of the fourth pin from the bottom, it'll be the sixth pin from the top. And again, if we consult the spare board that I have here, where the heck is it? Right here. Okay, get it to focus for a second. There we go. Okay, you see how it says AC underscore RLY? That stands for AC relay, okay? And that's the signal coming from the main board from this feedback loop saying, okay, you know, I've got your standby voltage, go ahead and turn your relay on. So that's 3.3 volts. But the relay itself is 12. The coil voltage is 12 for the relay, so the 3.3 doesn't automatically just turn the relay on. It's got to go through something to get stepped up to 12 volts. I honestly don't know what circuitry on the board steps it up to 12 volts. However, something steps it up to 12 volts and turns that relay on. If you don't hear that relay click, but you're getting the 3.3 volts, something is damaged between that signal and this relay. It's on this board for sure. If you're not getting the 3.3 volts, chances are that the main board is the problem, because that board is not sending the signal saying to turn the TV on, so you can't blame the power supply. It's got to be the main board. In this case, though, we're getting both the standby voltage and the AC relay voltage, so it's not related to the startup on the board or the main board or anything else like that. Somehow, the voltages that this relay is responsible for activating that go to these white connectors to the rest of the TV, somehow those voltages are there and they look stable in standby, but they're not stable when they're loaded. So something on this board is bad that's responsible for maintaining those voltages where they're supposed to be. Come to find out from doing research, and this is not obvious or anything, but come to find out that this IC chip up here, which is a Sony-branded IC chip, and I'll try to zoom in on it to give you an idea of what it looks like. Anyway, this IC chip here is responsible for producing the various voltages that go to those white connectors on the side. And when this thing goes, it tends to have this effect where the voltages are kind of unstable, and the TV will, you know, it'll progressively get worse and worse, where it'll fire up less often and less often. One way to actually verify this, and this is how I was able to verify it as well, is when this chip is in the process of failing, Often, if you heat it up with something like a hairdryer, it'll work temporarily. And actually, I had this idea before it was even suggested to me, but not for this component. I thought it was the relay that needed to be heated up because the contacts were all gummed up or something. But in fact, it wasn't that. It was this component all along. So if you take a hairdryer and you put it on there, heat it up until maybe 50 or 60 degrees Celsius, try to turn the TV on, chances are it'll fire up if this happens to be the defective component. So, obviously I'm getting yet another board because I already got this replacement board here, and this one doesn't work for a different reason. It's not the this chip in the case of this board. In the replacement board, the relay wouldn't even turn on, even though the voltage was there, which is what I mentioned earlier, right? So there's something damaged in the board that's responsible for that 12-volt coil voltage going to the relay. But in this original board, it's just this chip here that's defective. So I'm going to get a replacement board that hopefully will have no problems on it. However, since I've narrowed the problem down to this chip, if you were so inclined, you could actually desolder this thing and buy yourself a replacement chip, and you could bring this board back to 100% health again, and avoid paying the $40 that I had to pay for a replacement board. Now, the third board that I'm going to get is going to be free because it was the supplier's fault. However, I still had to pay $40 originally, so if I'm able to repair this one by swapping the chip out, I can just have a spare board. So pretty much this is like how I've gone about diagnosing the problem and how I've narrowed it down. And by going through this process, even though I'm not a TV repair guy, I think that I'm going to be able to save this board with a simple chip replacement, and then I'll have a good board. And the replacement one that I'm getting from the part supplier is going to be another second good board. So I'll have two good boards, two good power supply boards. And I didn't waste any money buying any other boards, like, for example, the TCON board up here, which is often a problem and can be easily misdiagnosed, or the main board in that chassis there. You know, I didn't have to go through in any wasted money buying other boards that could very easily be misdiagnosed as the problem, because you apply some simple reasoning and you understand how the TV works. So hopefully this video will give you enough understanding that you can do some basic diagnostics as well. Okay, so I've got the second replacement board installed, and let's fire it up and see if it works. Cross your fingers, because the first replacement board didn't work. All right. Heard the relay click, that's good news. Let's get the power button on here and check if there's a display. Sony bezel. No, hang on, something didn't work. Let's try again. There we go. Awesome. So hope this video helped you guys, and if you want to support my channel, please like, subscribe, and comment. Thanks a lot, and I'll see you next time.